Hello everyone. Today we will discuss logic, circuits, simplification. Before I start today's lecture, I would like to remind you few important points. Logical operators operate on binary values and binary variables, the three basic logic gates AND, OR, and NOT are logically complete because any Boolean expression can be realized as a logic circuit using only these three gates. There is only one way that a Boolean function can be represented in a truth table. However, when a Boolean function is represented in an algebraic expression form, point noted down, it can be expressed in a variety of ways, all of which perform the same logic. All the expressions will be equivalent. A particular logical expression used to represent the function tells the interconnection of gates to form a gating or logic network in the combinational logic circuit diagram. So the question is, how can we simplify logical expressions, or what is the need, what is the advantage to do this simplification? Now, logic circuit simplification can significantly reduce the cost of designing a logic circuit. Furthermore, the circuit reliability is improved because there are now fewer interconnections that can be potential circuit faults. Another calculated advantage of simplifying logic circuits is an increased operational speed of circuits. All logic gates are subjected to propagation delay. When logical changes in the inputs propagate through fewer layers of gates in order to find the output, the circuit operates fast. So, a Boolean expression can be manipulated according to Boolean algebra laws so that a simple expression can be obtained and further used in implementing a circuit for performing the desired logic but having fewer gates and interconnections. Now, what are the Boolean algebra laws? To start with, we discuss basic, OR, and complementation Boolean laws or identities in this video. OR laws. Take a variable, name it as A, which can take on only two values, 0 and 1. If the OR first rule states that A plus 0 is equal to A, second rule states that if we OR any variable with 1, the output is always 1. Third rule states that if a variable is OR'd with itself, the output is A. And if the fourth rule states that if a variable is OR'd with its complement, then the output is 1. How? Rule number 1, a variable odd with 0 is always equal to the variable. This rule is illustrated in these two figures where the lower input is fixed at 0. So we have fixed the lower input or one of the input to be 0. Now what will be the value of A? Assume first that A is equal to 0. Now 0 plus 0 as per the truth table of OR gate gives the output 0, which is equal to A. In second case, put one of the input 0 and take another input variable to be A. Now its value, assume its value to be 1, or them, so 1 plus 0 gives the output equal to 1, which is equal to A. So we can say that A plus 0 is equal to A. Rule number 2, any variable when it is odd with 1, it is always equal to 1, which means if there is 1 on any of the input of OR gate, it doesn't matter what is the value of the another input. It can be 0, it may be 1, but the output 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 1. When any of the input on an OR gate is 1, the output is equal to 1. So we can say that A plus 1 is equal to 1. Now moving back, AND laws, which states that if a variable is ANDed with 0, A dot 0 is 0. If any variable is ANDed with 1, it is equal to variable itself. And if any variable is ANDed with itself, the output is original variable. And if any variable is ANDed with its complement, it is equal to 0. Assume A is 0, then its complement is 1. So 0 dot 1 is 0. Now assume A to be equal to logic 1. Now its complement is 0. So 1 dot 0 is 0. So we will follow these laws to simplify our Boolean expression. These are the complementation rules. Rule 1. The double complement of a variable is always equal to the variable. Here you can see, if A is assumed to be equal to 0, then its complement denoted by A prime comes out to be 1. Now if we complement this A prime and pass it through an inverter NOT gate, then we get the output 0, which is equal to A. Okay, so the double complement of a variable is always equal to the variable. We can see it in the second case where we have assumed that A is equal to 1. Its inverted output is A prime is equal to 0. And when we complement it again, then this output comes out to be equal to 1, which is equal to A. So we can say that if A is complemented, if any variable is complemented twice, it is equal to the original variable. Complement of 0 is 1, complement of 1 is 0. If A is 0, then its complement is 1. If A is 1, then its complement is 0. This is all for this video. We will continue this topic in next video. Thank you so much for listening.